If the child cannot save both parents, maybe the child tried many, many times, but the child was not able to save the parents to avoid conflicts, then the child have to choose. Then the child decides, okay, I cannot save both, I must save at least one of them. And it depends. If a daughter becomes her mother's ally, then she develops a belief system that I cannot trust men, I have to rely always on myself. So she will be attracted to weak guys. She will not believe that the guy can help her. She will not believe that the guy can be the leader in the family. She will develop a belief system that I cannot trust men, I can rely only on myself. If the daughter becomes her father's ally, then she will take the place of her mother. She will say something like this: my mother is a terrible wife, so my father did not receive enough love, my mother did not respect him, my mother did not do this, this, and this, so I will give this for my father. Instead of my mother, I will replace her. And as a result, when he grows up, she will be dating a married man, or she will be attracted to man who has girlfriend, or she will be dating emotionally unavailable man, maybe a guy who still loves his ex, but he is with her, and she will try to play somebody else's role. She will try to... A lot of time this girl is not gonna date anyone because she wants to give her father what he did not receive from her mother. So she will live with her father for many, many years. She will cook for him, she will cheer him up, she will listen to him, she will become his best friend. But she's not gonna build her own life. She's not gonna build loving, healthy relationship in her own life with another man. I can see those people right away, and you can notice them too. When you talk to a person, maybe your girlfriend, maybe your co-worker at work, these people, they talk a lot about one parent. Like, the girl can talk about her mother, you know, non-stop. But when you ask her about the father, she can say something like, oh yeah, my father is well, he's okay, they still live together with my mom. So but she was talking only about her mother, so she is her mother's ally. Or maybe opposite, the girl will talk about her father, how smart he is, how great he is, and it feels like the mother died or something happened to her. But when you ask her, she's like, no, my mom is okay. She still lives with my dad. So in this is gonna be a signal for you that a person is still in relationship with her parent. She is not ready. She cannot build or create loving, healthy relationship with another man because she is still playing this triangle game. I will be ally for one of my parents because the second one is the bad one. So I have to glue this relationship. I have to give my mom or my dad love, care, support, respect that they did not receive from their partner. And let's talk about why this is bad. The child grows up and he cannot find his soulmate. He cannot create a happy romantic life, his own family. A person might spend too much time trying to make his parents happy. A woman is gonna call her mother every day. She will give or ask her advice in every situation. It can be a guy who needs his mother opinion on everything. And of course it's gonna ruin his life, ruin his own family. Another situation when a child is taking a partner's role for his parent. He can become a mother, a wife for her father, or a guy can decide, you know what, my dad is bad, I will be the boss in my family. I will replace my father. I will be the husband for my mother. And this child will be always available for his parent. The child might be in his 30s, 40s, or 50s, but he's gonna say something like, I'm gonna help to mom always. I'm always here for my mom. If mom calls, I have to stop everything and go and help her, go to rescue her. If the girl was raised without the father, or father was absent, maybe he was sick, maybe he was a workaholic, maybe he was emotionally unavailable, maybe he did not know how to give love, how maybe he never kissed his daughter. So the daughter will be attracted to older men who is 10 and more years older than her. She will be looking for father's daughter relationship. Another example, if a mother was the bad mother, the bad one, and her daughter might develop two type of scenarios. One, she can say, I will be strong as my father, I will be the responsible one. My mom is weak, my mom cannot take responsibility of anything, so I will be as my father, I will be the controlling one. I have to control everything in order for it to work. And of course she's gonna attract weak men, of course she's gonna attract poor guys, because a strong, successful man, he needs a soft, feminine woman. Second scenario, when the mother was the bad one, the daughter might try to replace her. And she will be always available for her father, and she will say, you know, my mom was... She's not gonna say it. This is how the trauma works. This is how the algorithm mechanism, a defensive mechanism is created. So the daughter will say something like, I can never betray my father. My mom betrayed him. My mom was not gentle enough, was not kind enough. She did not understand him. So I will be the one who will do everything for my father. I will never betray him. My father is the best man. No other man can replace him. And as a result, she can be lonely for the rest of her life. And she cannot be truly happy because she is devoted, loyal to her father. She is so loyal that she cannot go and find another man.